Hey folks, it's Lucy with Ballyhoo Creations, and I have not made a YouTube video in so long because I've been so busy with other things. Still making videos, but not necessarily for YouTube. I've been doing video tutorials on Creative Fabrica for a new ragdoll, a couple of sewing patterns actually, some monsters I made, a ragdoll pattern I made for the sewing machine, and then I did my cloth characters on the embroidery machine. That's the latest class that I'm waiting for them to get up. And I'm also learning how to teach on Skillshare, so I'm going to move over there and do some things as well, and maybe do both, I don't know, and then I'll keep doing the YouTube. I still have two more beginner videos for YouTube, the ones on designs, like where do designs come from, because people think that you buy an embroidery machine and you just make your own designs. That's how Cricut works, right? So embroidery machine should be the same, and it's so not the same. So I want to do a video on that, and then just troubleshooting, like when you have bird's nests or puckering or all those problems. So that will be in the beginner series, and I'm hoping to get those finished in the next month. And I'm still making videos, like I said, so they're YouTube, but then also over on Skillshare and Creative Fabrica. And then I'm still designing. I'm still working on new designs for dolls. I'll show you a couple things that I'm working on. So the cloth characters, this is the Creative Fabrica class that I did, and this pattern is actually included with that class. There's the body, and then the head, and the ears are included, and the hands are included, and the hat is included. So there's five different patterns, and this is the advanced cloth character class, because it shows you how to put the armatures in, and the fur trim, and all that good stuff, stitching the ears in the hoop. And like I said, these are the same pattern and the same face, so I just switched up the materials, and you can see how different they look with just a material change. Like, I went from an elf to a witch just with the materials. This is a red fleece, and this is a black scuba fabric, which looks really neat. I got some more scuba to make dolls with, because it's really cool. And then different hair, and the elf hat was just turned into a witch hat. I mean, how crazy is that, that the same pattern looks so different? And all dolls are like that. I try to stress that. I've got, this is a sewing pattern for a rag doll, and the face design is included, that you trace and go over it with, you trace it with a pencil and then go over it with fabric markers. And then it includes a little skirt here, and it shows you how to make the yarn hair. That's also a class on Creative Fabric I did. The silly baby, I really like this rag doll, and you can see the difference in size. Like, these are the, Miss Witchy just can't keep her head on straight. These rag dolls, these are even small, but you can see how big and bulky they are compared to the character dolls that I do. These are more like home decor. Because of the armatures, the wires in there, you wouldn't want to give this to a child. But this is definitely a child's doll with, I mean, there's the embroidered face, and there's no plastic parts or anything. And it comes with the t-shirt too. So I digitized the t-shirt to fit the baby. The diaper is included with the pattern, like it's all done in the hoop. These have two different sizes, and this took me forever to figure out. I can't tell you how long I struggled with, like, how to do the neck. So in a 5x7 hoop, you do the arms and legs as one hooping, and then the body is a hooping, and then the head is a separate hooping, and then you hand stitch the head onto the body, and then the t-shirt's a separate hooping as well. But if you have a 6x10 hoop, you make the same size doll, but the head and the body fit in the 6x10 hoop, so it's one less hand stitching. And this is kind of tricky to hand stitch on, so if you have a 6x10 hoop, I think it's much easier. But I went ahead and made it for 5x7 as well, because I really love this silly baby pattern. I love the goofy face. There's actually two. One doesn't have the eyelashes. There's just the white outline, and then the other has the dark, like, eyeliner and the eyelashes. And I'm also working on something else. These are not out yet. These are still being prototyped, but these are what I call bag dolls, but in the doll making world, you would call these a stump doll, because there's no legs or anything intended. A lot of times they don't even have arms, although I may add arms, and they're just, like, usually you put something heavy in the bottom. I put some rice in this one, or pellets or something, and they'll stand on their own really well. I've even boxed the bottom here with the box corners. I can't do that in the hoop, though. I mean, you could, but I don't think I'm going to. There's different methods to flatten the bottoms of these, but this leaves you a nice big surface for embroidering or even printing. I'm trying to find some examples of printed fabric. I don't have any right here, but I'm trying to get into the print, like print something on your fabric and then stitch it on your embroidery machine. And that's because I love a good challenge. And I don't know if anybody's doing that. Maybe they are, and I just haven't seen it. But I don't have a sublimation printer yet, but I've been looking at them for a long time, and I'm thinking maybe I'll buy one. But I print on fabric by using Terrial Magic. You spray it on your fabric, and then when you iron it, it gets really stiff, and you can run it through a regular inkjet printer. I don't know how washable that is. I haven't washed mine yet. But you could also do stuff like freezer paper. Back in the day, I used bubble jet set and freezer paper to print on fabric. I've been printing on fabric a long time, and what I love about it, and this, I don't mean to make this sound like a commercial, but since I have that Creative Fabrica membership, I can buy any design or pattern for scrapbooking is mainly what those are for. But once you get that pattern, you can print it on fabric. And now you have your own custom fabric. And yeah, you're limited in size. If you have a regular printer, you're 8.5 by 11. I have a large format printer and it will do 11 by 17. So I can get a good size of fabric. But for in the hoop projects, which is what I do, my biggest hoop is 8 by 12. I mean, that's an 8.5 by 11 sheet of fabric. So really, for in the hoop projects and printing fabric, just a regular printer is enough for me, because I don't need big, huge pieces of fabric. I just need small pieces. So I'm going to work on that, because that would mean, and I'm not going to get rid of my fabric stash, and I'm working on stuff now. Look at all this stuff back here. But being able to print on demand whenever I'm like, oh, this designer came out with these beautiful new graphics and backgrounds, and just throw some custom-made fabric together and then make a doll, I think that's really cool. So I'm working on that too. It's all like up here and getting onto the computer and then and getting tested in the next week or so. So I've been so busy, and I had a really bad week a couple weeks ago. With like everything went wrong. Everything I did went wrong. I recorded a long swath of video and my audio, like you couldn't hear anything I was saying, and I had to go and fix that. And then, but I couldn't fix it because it rained for a week, thunderstorms, and I couldn't record with storms. And then the rain finally stopped. And then my neighbor cut down a tree right outside this window right here, and I couldn't even hear myself think. And it was just one of those weeks where I felt like the whole universe is against me and I shouldn't even be doing this. I'm just ready to throw in the towel. I was thinking like, I wonder if Amazon would even hire me at their warehouse, because they probably wouldn't. What would I do? But things got better. I mean, we all have those weeks. I know I'm not alone. I know we all have those weeks, and they do pass. I just keep telling myself it's not a bad life, just a bad day, maybe a bad week. Maybe a bad year. Yeah, I know I'm starting to sound like the theme song to Friends, but I love that show, by the way. It was a bad week, but it got better, and I'm back on the chugging along train, and still back to making videos, back to making more dolls, back to making more embroidery designs, trying to figure out new things, make crazy new things that other people haven't made before, because that's, I love that. That's my zone. Like, no one's tried this. Let me try it. See what happens. So I'm curious to hear, like, how do you get over your adversity when things are really getting you down, whether it's with crafting or something else, but especially with crafting, because, you know, you might make something the first time. And now that I'm teaching more, I'm really interested in this. Like, if something you're struggling with, how do you get yourself to keep pushing through? Because I know I've learned through the years, and I've been doing this a lot of years. I know that the first 2 to 3 tries wasted. Just they're usually going to be poopy, and I just kind of account for that. I don't even use good materials for them, and then sometimes they turn out great. I'm like, oh man, I wish I'd done a better material with this, because this is good. What do you like? How do you think through and just keep going? Like, do you have a certain number? Like, my number's three. Go ahead and make 3 and see if it gets better. Because if it doesn't get better by 3. I might not waste my time on 4. I've got a lot of projects that didn't make it to 4. A lot of projects, 1 and 2, they turn out. But I'm curious, like, tell me in the comment section, when you're having a really bad time with your craft or your art or something like that, what tricks do you have to tell your brain to get back in there and keep doing it? Because, you know, if you don't know, let me tell you, if you just keep doing it, it does get better. That practice really does improve. And you got to get through, I call it, you got to get through the suck. You got to get through the sucky part where everything's horrible and get through the suck to the success. Success even has the word suck in it. You got to get through the suck to the success. And that's my trick. What tricks do you have? Because I'm willing to try anything. Because like I said, the last 2 weeks ago, I was just like, I couldn't sleep at night. And I started taking melatonin. That's how bad it is, which was working for me. So curious, leave a comment. That's all I got. I will be getting back to beginner videos pretty soon. And if there's anything else that you really want to see for machine embroidery or doll making, I would love to hear what you have to say. And that's all I got. So now go make some stuff.